Moses had a showdown with Pharaoh. Jesus had a showdown with the devil.
If you will bow down and worship me, I will give you the whole world.
I worship the Lord, my God, only.
And all of them, in their showdown, they overcame. And you, what has been your challenge? Is it a disease? Debt? Addiction? Family problems? And more.
Kill yourself.
Who's winning? The Showdown of Faith is for you to overcome. And you are going to destroy this problem that has been a monster. A giant that is defiling you. Provoking you.
I take the scissors right here. Snap you.
Day by day. According to the World Health Organization, the number of people with an anxiety disorder in the world increased by 18.4% in the last 10 years. There has never been as much medicine sold today to control anxiety than there ever was before. Anxiety is characterized by too much fear, the fear of what will or will not happen. This disorder triggers a wave of hormones that creates a physical reaction in the body. Common symptoms of anxiety disorder are excessive sweating, dizziness, tremors, rapid heartbeat, lack or excess sleep, excess hunger or lack of appetite, disinterest in activities, and even suicidal thoughts. Anxiety is triggered when one's emotions become too overwhelming and prevents them from taking care of their tasks and commitments. Anxiety disorder can progress into depression. It is estimated that 4 out of 5 depressed patients initially had anxiety.
Hello, friend. May the God of the Bible bless you. You're watching now your program, Showdown of Faith. As you watch this video talking about anxiety, there are many people in this exact moment that anxiety have been taking place in their life. There are many people that they are depressed because they cannot afford to go to work. There are many people that they lost their job. Plenty of people, they don't know how they're going to be able to pay their rent, the mortgage of the house. There are many people depressed because the bills are piling up. They cannot pay the car. They cannot pay their employers. Many business people, they have been closed, shut down their business, and that's the reason why it's caused a lot of depression in many people's lives. And perhaps you have been watching me right now and you are depressed. And I'm going to tell you today what you need to do in order for you to overcome your depression. I would like you to prepare a glass of water I have in mind here. And at the end of this program, I'm going to say a special prayer on your behalf. I would like you to take a look in this Bible verse. Look what the Bible says in the book of Proverbs, chapter 12, verse 25. The Bible says here, anxiety in the heart of a man causes depression, but a good word makes it glad. Pastor Andrew, he right now on our altar, I am here on the studio. Pastor Andrew, he's there. And beside him, he has Pastor Dell. Pastor Andrew, there are many people in this exact moment that they are depressed. Because of this coronavirus, there are many family that they don't know what to do.
Yes, Pastor Junior, this person who is watching to this program and is feeling depressed, feeling down because of a family problem, a financial problem, because of the situation that she or he is going through right now. I would like you to stop all that you are doing, if that's possible for you. You are going to watch to this testimony, Miss Misha. What God did for her, He also will do for you. There is a way out. There is a solution to your problem. Let us watch now. I'll be back in a few minutes with all of you.
Before coming to the Universal Church, I had lots of problems. Financial problems in my marriage, problems with my children. We used to sell on the street most of the time. We sell like soft drinks and cigarettes and stuff on the street. Things just get hard for us. We don't know why. Things just got hard. We never used to make money much. The little money we made, we used to spend it on the children and stuff like that. We could not save anything. If we make a little money, we could not save anything. I used to cry a lot. Cry a lot concerning, well, why things not going right for me? Why my husband behaving like that? But eventually, well, I got fed up. I decided, well, best I just take everything and just go. Nothing can work out for us. So I decided, I was thinking about taking everything and go. I saw the Universal Church on TV. Yes, and I was cleaning out home one day, and the TV was on, the TV on that station, and decided to sit down and watch the program. He wanted to come to the church. After this Friday service, he decided, well, okay, we'll go to the church. Because we were looking for somewhere to go to solve our problems, to help solve our problems. So we decided, okay, we'll go to the church.
With our finances, life was real ups and downs. At least for me, I used to get real angry. I used to quarrel, take out my anger. And a lot of stuff used to come within my angerness. But as we started to go to the Universal Church, I see changes in my life. A lot of changes. When my wife came to me and told me, well, she wanted to rent a place to open a restaurant. I said, how me here? I said, you know, I'm the jack of all trades. Is there anything I could do? She said, well, all right. We go and look for a place to get the rent.
We talked to the agent instead of the owner. So the agent put us on to the owner, and we had a conversation with her. She told us to come in for an interview to see if we'll be able to rent the place. So we went in for the interview. We spoke to her. We told her what we wanted to open and stuff like that. But she said it was okay. It's not a problem for me to open that day, but we have to pay a certain amount of money before we open. We showed a few of our friends, family, the place, and they told us that it was too high up. Don't go ahead with it because you wouldn't sell anything. Nobody wouldn't come up so high to buy anything. It's just out of the way, out of town. Don't go there. So I say, I'll go ahead with it. I will use my faith. I'll go ahead with it because God wouldn't lead me wrong.
Everything around us started to change completely. Customers upon customers. We had to watch one another and say, well, see, she had to run and go out. When she cooked in the back, she had to run and go outside in front to help serve. And from since then, we started to see people coming from the city gate, PTSA workers coming up. City council workers has come. Things getting better every and every day by the grace of God.
Soon, I believe that we need to get a bigger place because it's just too small. The amount of people that comes into the restaurant daily is just too small. Everything is fine. Everything is good with us in that restaurant. Every daily restaurant grows, like more people come in every daily.
Those who are there watching my testimony, my wife and I, just don't get frustrated. Just use your faith. And God will bless you the same way He blessed me and my wife.
In the same way that God, He blessed the life of Miss Misha, also He can bless your life. Now, I would like to call Pastor Dale. He's going to call some names, people who have been called or text for us to place their name inside of the whole oil. Pastor Dale is with you.
Within you, there is victory and defeat. What determines one or the other is your mentality. If you believe you were born to suffer, then you will. However, if you believe that the abundant life that God has promised is for you, then you will prosper.
Yes, Pastor, we have people that are calling, that are texting, sending us their requests. Someone from Clarkson Bay that want to be anonymous. He said that he's depressed and he really needs help. So, sir, your name and also this request for you to be free from depression is in the holy oil. Also, Pastor Donna Haywood from Gasparillo. She's having job problems and also she's having marital problems between her and her husband. Well, your name and your request is inside of the holy oil. Also, Pastor Peter, he needs total healing, his health. He's having problems with his health. Well, if you are having a health issue just like Peter, you can send us your text message, 389-9880 and 709-8062. I will get your name and I'll place your name inside of the holy oil for your life to begin to change. Pastor, also, Elsie, she needs healing. She is not remembering properly. So, Miss Elsie, your name is inside of the holy oil. Also, Natasha and Keisha, they want their names to be placed in the holy oil, them and their family members from Clarkson Bay and from El Dorado. Well, your name and your family members is in the holy oil, and she's also asking for protection. Pastor, we have Amit as well, that wants total healing because his blood sugar level is very high. Mr. Abdul, your name is inside of the holy oil. And if you are sick, you are having health complications, call us now. We are going to help you. Also, Pastor, we have Bharat that needs protection for him and his family from this COVID-19, from the coronavirus. Well, your request and your name is inside of the holy oil. Also, Pastor, we have Mala. Mala wants prayer for her family. Her mom, her dad, and her son is sick. It's almost the entire family inside of the house. They are not well presently. Well, your name and your request, your family members inside the holy oil. And for sure, you are going to recover from this infirmity. Anita, Pastor, she's calling for protection for her family. Anita, your name and your request is inside of the holy oil. Also, Pastor Gita, Matthew, and Isabella, they are in need of protection. And Pastor, many people, they are calling, asking for protection. Also, Rennie Jagunath, that is having financial problems, Pastor Junior. He's saying that work is very slow. So he would like you to make a special prayer today for him as we place his name into the holy oil. Back to you, Pastor Junior.
Well, friend, if you want to overcome your depression, stay with us because we are going to help you. You can keep call us. You can keep WhatsApp us because we are going to help you. You are going to watch now a video of the Universal Church work that we have been done here in Trinidad and Tobago. I would like you to watch it and I'll be back with you in a few.
Unisocial Trinidad and Tobago, reaching out to those in need. Our first outreach program started in the community of Cocorite, where hampers were given to the elderly people, widows, and some single parents who don't even have an idea of how to provide for their children.
The Unisocial group here in Trinidad and Tobago, twice a week, every Mondays and Fridays, we have prepared this great table here to share with those who are homeless. And we have determined, Bishop, that many people who have been coming here to receive this breakfast, their lives will change, because we have testimonies of people that once here in Trinidad, in the streets of Trinidad and Tobago, they were beggars, they were begging, they were homeless, but through the Unisocial group, many of them have been restored. They have been put back into the society.
Moving towards Riverside Plaza, where the homeless who have been rejected by their families and society were not only treated to a hot meal, but also received spiritual upliftment for their souls.
The Lord Jesus said that He's the living bread that came down from heaven. And if you seek Him with all your heart, with all your soul, you will be able not only to find what you can see here, but you shall have eternal life. This is what is the most important thing. You can join us here in Trinidad and Tobago. We need your help. those of you that can donate, those of you that can stretch out your hands to help those who are in need. Because in this ministry, those that have more, they help others. And those who don't have nothing, for sure, they are going to receive the helping hand of those who have a little bit more.
In the Greenville community, many people lost most of their basic necessities due to the biggest flood that occurred in this country. Another great effort to meet those in need with the distribution of over 2,500 hampers in time for the season of Christmas.
Because together with the government of Trinidad and Tobago PNF, we are going to be helping many more families, not only 2,500, but we want really to help everyone who are in need.
Wallerfield Jacob Hill Activity Center, where bright smiles were seen on the faces of the children because of the surprise bouncy castle and special treats for all of them. Manicures, hairstyles, barbering, facials, free blood pressure testing, and much more. San Migrande, where the rehab course was introduced to the women who have been facing challenges within themselves without any way of getting the help they desperately needed.
My God, in the name of your Son, Jesus, Father, we give you thanks for you to give us the opportunity to be helping the community of Sandy Grande today. And we are happy, my Father, to come on board with Minister Mrs. Glenda Janice Smith. And we ask you, Holy Spirit, for you to bless my Father this day, for you to take direction of everything that we are going to do here right now. Because everything, my God, is for your glory. And we know that, Father, you will bring peace, you bring joy, bring, my Father, blessings to Sandy Grande. Lord, we ask you, Lord, for you to bless this food. Bless those that have prepared, those that have helped, donated. And in the name of Jesus, we determine and we declare, Father, that as we are helping the people here in the community of Sandy Grande, my God, let this food be like medication, strength to all of them that receive it. In Jesus' name, amen.
My name is Marlon Izama. Before I received the Holy Spirit, I used to have a lot of addictions. I used to have lots of fun. And through that lots of fun, it became addiction to me by liming, drinking, smoking, having a lot of women. I thought I was enjoying life, but through that, it had an emptiness inside of me. And I always thought that I was missing something. And through these addictions, I had a lot of friends. We used to go online, party a lot, drink a lot. It had times that I could not used to wait to reach home. to go and drink, to go and sit down by the bar. And then I spend nights out drinking, smoking, just thinking, thought I was enjoying myself, but it wasn't. And then I was there invited to the church, the Universal Church, and I decided to sit and listen to the pastor preach. I listened to testimonies talking about the Holy Spirit, how they received the Holy Spirit, what they had, and I decided to give it a shot. I used to be one way in the church and still go outside and still do this stuff, still drink a little, still smoke. Didn't used to be much like before, but I still used to do it because I could not stop. And one day it just hit me and I decided to give my all. And I was there pouring my all out, telling God how much I wanted to receive His Spirit, because He said without His Spirit you would not be saved. So I decided I wanted to be saved. I had that desire to receive that Holy Spirit as well. So I pursued against it. I went, I gave my all. And then it just happened. I just received that assurance that the Holy Spirit is with me. And through that, it was like, it just take all the pains, all the burdens, everything that I had inside of me, come like He just replaced it with something different, a total different person, a different spirit, right? Which is the Holy Spirit. And after that, it was just, my whole life just changed. Totally changed, transformed. I no longer smoke, I no longer drink, I no longer go to parties. None of these things don't even interest me anymore. All that interests me is that I want to serve God and I want to give my all, my best to do it.
Yes, Pastor John, in the same way the Spirit of God, He can come upon this man, He can come upon this woman. In the same way that the Bible says the Spirit of God came upon Abraham, also He can come upon this man, upon this woman, to give to her, to give to him strength so that they may overcome every situation that they are going through.
Of course, Pastor Andre, I have no doubt that the Spirit of God, He will bless this person. The Spirit of God, He will bless you. I would like to read it to you, this Bible verse. The Bible says here in the book of Exodus, chapter 12, verse 3. The Bible says here, "Speak to all the congregation of Israel, saying, on the 10th day of this month, every man shall take a lamb, according to the house of their father, a lamb for a household." Friend, we understand that God gave that direction because a plague was about to come to the country of Egypt. And for those who belong to God and will obey the voice of God, God gave it to them that direction for them to prepare themselves against that plague. And nowadays, we are facing one of the worst moments in our lives because of this coronavirus, that we can say that it is a plague. And because of this coronavirus, there are many people that they are afraid. They are afraid because they have been facing a lot of problems. Many people, they are sent back home. Many people, they cannot afford to go to work. There are plenty of people that right now, they are worrying how they are going to be able to pay their bills, how they are going to be able to provide for their family. But we believe, Pastor Andre, that God will provide for them, and also God will protect them. And that's the reason why we are inviting everybody to prepare a bottle, a small bottle of grape juice, because Friday, Pastor Andrew, when they receive one direction that we are going to be giving to them, God will protect their family.
Yes, Pastor John, that's why I already prepared my bottle of grape juice, because the Bible says that plague shall not come near to your house. And you who are watching to this program right now, you should prepare also your bottle of grape juice. For this Friday, we have been received a direction from above, from God, that this direction will bless you and your house. All that you have to do is to prepare this bottle of grape juice and be with us this Friday.
That's right, Pastor Andre. Have no doubt that God will bless there. Well, friend, prepare your small bottle of grape juice, because on Friday, you are going to receive one direction that's going to protect you and also your entire family. Now is the moment for us to talk with God. I believe that you have already there with you a glass of water. Before I pray, let me remind you that our numbers is still available to you. Our numbers are 389-9880 or 709-8062. If you'd like to place your name, your family names inside of the holy oil, you can call us right now. I have it here on my phone. You can WhatsApp me right now. You can call, because we are going to help you. Well, friend, get yourself ready, because now is the moment for us to talk with God.
Are you feeling down and depressed? Frustrated, like there is no way out? God said, then you will call on me and come and pray to me, and I will listen to you. This opportunity is now. Stop everything you are doing and get your glass of water. It's time for a moment of prayer.
My God and my Father, in the name of your Son Jesus, my Lord, there are many people right now desperate. There are many people right now wondering and worrying how they are going to be able to provide for their family, how they are going to be able, Lord, to pay their bills, to pay their rent. My Lord, there are many people that unfortunately they don't know what to do. There are many people, Father, that even suicidal thoughts have been coming in their minds. There are many people, Father, that they are in need of help. Lord, I pray on behalf of this man. He's the provider. He's the man of the house. But right now, he feels like hopeless. He feels, my Lord, like nothing, because he cannot provide to his family. It seems like there is nothing that he can do in order for him to help his children. I ask you, Lord, help this person right now. My Father, our eyes are on you. We need your help. If you don't help us, Lord, nobody else can help us. Father, I ask you for you to open the doors, bring prosperity. Show to this person what they have to do. Lord, I pray on behalf of those who are in quarantine, those who are in the hospital, those who have already this coronavirus. Lord, set this person free right now. Deliver this person, Lord. Do not allow this evil, my God, to destroy this person. Holy Spirit, my Father, I ask you, consecrate, sanctify this glass of water, for when this person, they drink of it, let this person to receive your power. My God, I surrender this person's life into your mighty hands, and I determine right now their freedom, their blessing, their healing from this depression. And whoever believes, say amen. Do you believe, dear friend? You can drink right now from your water. Well, friend, I have no doubt that the Spirit of God, He is with you. I would like to let you know that the altar of God is not in quarantine. Those of you that have been faithful to God, the altar of God is there to receive your prayer. If you'd like to come by the church by yourself, we are not congregating, we are not have service, But if you'd like to come by the church and present your prayer, present your life, you can feel yourself free. May the God of the Bible bless you. I wish you a happy and a good day. The video that you are going to see now is a life story of people that God helped them and they overcame. God bless you.